Hey, I'm Clayton Genelon Grimen. Today we're doing ab abdominal region. It's incredibly difficult to sculpt, even for someone like me who doesn't have a lot of body fat. Abs primarily are determined by genetics, also by diet. Diet with abdominal muscles is very hard to configure because it has to be a lot of protein, very, very little fat. And with me being a vegetarian, the protein is something that I don't get an adequate amount of. But I'm going to show you what I do. What I've got here is a 25-pound weight. This just came from a standard like Walmart, Target store. Just went in and purchased one off the shelf. If you're just starting out, don't start with a 25-pound weight. Keep in mind also that I am in no way a fitness trainer. I do what I know is right for my body, but my body is not your body. So you most assuredly want to make certain that you're doing something that's not going to do any detrimental harm to yourself before you start any exercise. Because something like this looks very innocent, but this 25-pound weight can do your body an enormous amount of harm. So when you're starting out, start out very, very lightly and work your way up to higher weights. So what I'm doing, I'm putting my finger here just so I can feel the motion of the weight as it goes down. And what you're doing is just doing it basically. Some on this side. Then you switch over, do it to the other. And of course you do more repetitions. I'm just keeping them light right now just to give you an idea of how I work my abs. I realize I do not have a 6-pack or an 8-pack, maybe not even a 4-pack, but keeping it lean is the goal. If you get the abs by keeping it lean, eating a good diet, and doing light exercise, then wonderful. If not, at least you're trying and making this exercise. What I'm doing is I'm taking this, putting it behind my back, like so, and lifting it up and down. I'll show you from the opposite side. Just like that. One thing that you have to keep in mind when working your abdominal muscles is that they're in correlation with your back muscles. And if you hurt your back, you're going to be in for a world of pain. And this exercise portion is the most strenuous on your back. So you might want to skip this if you've had any kind of back problems at all. And basically now, for this part, I'm basically planking it. I'm standing here still. And take it behind your head. Go over. Over. And you can feel it. Also, you can take your hand, extend it, reach down. And you want to be doing what's known as a fitness instructor once taught me, as the Pilates zip up. You want to be taking your core, you want to be activating it, and you can feel when your core is activated because it's hard, it's lean. And that's what I'm feeling here. There's no stomach pooching, which is also a term a fitness trainer once used with me, and which I've never forgotten. Because it's good terminology. It means that you're not going to forget it. Be careful and cautious. Once again, I can usually go higher, but with the jeans, it's limiting my motion here. And if you want to do it in another advanced, and this is something else again where you have to watch your back very carefully. Stand and swing just slightly. Again, you can feel your abs engaged. Switch it over. Do some for this side. It's good to do this in front of a mirror, especially when there's high light. When you can see in high light the contortion of the muscles. And it's very helpful to get a visual effect that you're working on. But thank you for working out with me today. I just do this sometimes around the house when I get bored, a few times a week. Even your abs, I've heard some trainers say that you can work them every day. However, other trainers have told me just to give it a day off every now and again for recovery. And so every now and again, especially on the Sabbath, don't work out on the Sabbath. It's just a day God gave us rest, and you can do good on the Sabbath, but sure, it's good for your abs, but it's one day you can skip. God bless you all. Thank you for working out.